Hi, it's Jacob here, and in today's short quick tip, I'm going to show you how to level up your screenshots on iPad and iPhone with some really handy tips. We'll start on iPad, and I'll take a screenshot of this very attractive looking YouTube page. Now, in the bottom corner, my screenshot shows up in a floating window, and if we tap on there, we can get straight into the screenshot editing tools. The first thing to do is to crop it down slightly to get rid of some of the toolbars and make the screenshot a little bit more focused. So I'll do that by dragging in the corners. Now after that, we're going to use the annotation tools. On the left-hand side of my screen, you can see my drawing tools there. If you haven't got them yet, press the button in the top corner that I'm pointing to now. We're not going to use the drawing tools as such, but we are going to press the plus button on the bottom of that toolbar. And from here, we can add some more elements on top of our screenshot. We'll start off with the magnifier. When I select that tool, it'll drop a circular magnifying glass on top of my screenshot. Obviously, I can move that around, and the green dot at the top, if you slide that around, will change the zoom level. Also, blue dot at the bottom will make the circle bigger or smaller. This magnifier is a great way of highlighting a certain part of your page, like, I don't know, the subscribe button? We can also edit the magnifying glass to give it a thinner or a thicker edge as well, just like this. Of course, we can add other elements as well, and I'll tap on that plus button again, and then from here I'm going to choose an arrow. The great thing is, all of these tools have got customization built in, so you can position either end, or you can grab the middle dot to make it a curved and bendy arrow. When the element is in position, we can then change how it looks as well by tapping on this options button. We can make the arrow double-ended, single-ended, or just a straight line, and we can make it thin, medium, or thick as well. And let's not forget we've got the colour picker there to colour all of these elements should you wish. There's no real limit to how many elements you add to your screenshot, but remember you're trying to draw attention to something in particular, not overwhelm the person that gets your screenshot. When you're finished, press done and then save to photos. Now if we jump over to the iPhone, you have access to all of these tools as well. So let's quickly put a magnifier on this screenshot. There's one tool on the iPhone that isn't on the iPad. I'm not sure why, but it's really handy, and it's called opacity. That opacity tool will let you dim the background of your screenshot, but any elements on top, like arrows or text or magnifying glasses, will stay the same. That really helps focus the viewer's attention to a particular part of the screenshot. And again, just like before, you can press done when you're ready. Your screenshots have never looked this good, and now you can make them just the way you want. I hope you found this video helpful. There are literally hundreds more on my YouTube channel down below, so make sure you head over there now. I'll see you next time.